Lego is bringing Sauron into physical form with Barad-dûr. We're getting a new gift with purchase from Lego Ideas, and we're going to discuss why Lego is putting its full force behind Fortnite. All that and much more on this week's Breaking News. Today's episode is brought to you by Back to Brickware, my newest venture into the Aful merchandise, the ultimate Lego-inspired clothing line that's not just fashionable, but also celebrates the very foundation of the Lego system we all know and love. Imagine minimalist designs that seamlessly blend style and nostalgia. Back to Brickware brings you high-quality apparel inspired by the iconic Lego bricks we know and love. Each piece is crafted with precision and attention to detail, making it a must-have for any Lego enthusiast. These aren't just your average threads. We're talking about minimalist designs that don't scream at you, but just show your nerddom in a classy way. And of course, they're inspired by designs found in the Lego system. And you know what screams quality? Embroidery. Almost every piece is stitched with love, featuring those iconic Lego elements. It's like wearing your childhood memories, but making them fashionable. So whether you're a hardcore AFOL or just want to rock some seriously cool gear, check out the Back to Brickware page on Etsy. Dive into the collection, embrace the Lego spirit, and let's make some memories together. Back to Brickware, where the style meets nostalgia. Head over to the Back to Brick Etsy page and let the fashion adventure begin. Happy building, my friends.
Lego.
Lego.
Breaking news. Hey everybody, welcome back to Back to Brick. I'm your host Garrett, and this is the podcast where we talk with fellow Aples about their Lego designs, and we get down to the breaking news to talk about all things Lego has been up to for the past week. Thank you for all those who are avid listeners, and thank you for all those that are newcomers coming to listen to the podcast. Come here and listen to all the great news that we have, understanding what has been going on for the past week, because there's always more than you'd expect. I also want to thank our Lego patrons over our Back to Brick Patreon. These people are getting the podcast early, they're getting without ads, they're going to get special things such as Lego designs that I've done for free as I'm still building instructions for things. We have discussions, so many really fun things, and it definitely helps the Back to Brick brand as I continue to build it through YouTube, the podcast, which I'd love if you subscribe to the YouTube because we're almost to 1,000 by my birthday, June 7th. Let's try to get people to go over, check it out. I do my brick by brick challenge, some vlogs, some other design things, and trying to learn what exactly you want from this from the YouTube, because I wanna add to it. But I'm going to thank Bellefonte Brick Studio, Ryan Moore, Franco Portelli, Jimmy Tucker, Ryan S., David, Matthew, Vander Bogart, Paul, Snellen, and Lee Jackson. Thank you so much for being a supporter of the Back to Brick brand. For the admin of the podcast, not much going on. I've been sorting a lot of parts, trying to get the best thing I can for my clients that I'm doing my commissions for, and working on, just keeping up to date with things, a lot of social and editing, video editing. It's so annoying. I wish that it was just videotape and it could be edited. I'm waiting for that AI to come out to make something viral because, well, it's not easy and it takes a lot of effort to do that. And just been kind of tired just trying to go through this, and I'm still not in my full-time position that I accepted, and it's probably not going to be anytime soon. So this is just exactly what I'm doing, trying to build this and trying to make it successful. But that's pretty much it. We're going to be doing our set reviews and our set review and rubricable mock review. Today's set review is 10297, the Modular Build Boutique Hotel. And the rubricable mock review is the Mini Scale Barad-dûr mock by Dopey 1479. So stay tuned for that after the breaking news. So let's get into it. On to the breaking news. The moment we've all been waiting for. Barad-dûr has officially been revealed. This set 10333. It is 5,471 pieces, rated for 18 plus, and will come at a cost of $460. I will be putting a referral link in the description so you can go purchase that, and it will be available on June 1st. Now, this is a very impressive model. We've got a total of 5 minifigures, brand new Gollum minifigure, 10 minifigures, not 5. 10 minifigures, including a new Gollum print, Frodo and Sam, which are the same figures that we got in Rivendell, and then they have orc helmets, so they don't have any other printing on their clothes. A couple of the other ones, we have Sauron himself in brand new molding. This is his physical form, so Lego has brought him back in physical form, and just don't give him the ring, which unfortunately Frodo has, so hopefully that doesn't get to his hands. And the Messenger of Sauron, which they've done in a previous set, and it's always creepy. There's a couple orcs. The tower is, it's huge. I believe it's one of the tallest Lego sets that they've ever built. It has, of course, the Great Eye in the top, and it actually does light up with a red brick on the backhand side. A lot of trans pieces, trans orange and red. I would say that they have bars that hold it in place at the top, which if only they could have done that in like trans, transparent Technic pieces for it, but I think it was fine. The back side of the tower itself has a lot of little details. Some are interesting. I didn't really know what they were going to put behind here because, honestly, I don't really check behind the Rivendell set, so this is something I wouldn't check behind either. It has a little lava pit where they put some a skeleton down in. There's a dining hall, someone called it, for the orcs. It's got a full table. I don't think that that's how they would eat. The next floor up is Sauron's throne, but what's cool is you can pull out a little knob and his throne splits in half and there's seeing stones, and it has the Tree of Gondor burning, which I'm pretty sure is going to be a hint to getting that, as well as the Shire burning, which that would be also a really cool set if they did a Hobbiton as like a large set like this. So hopefully those two will be in our future. Then of course there's lava all around and the tower itself can be disconnected and raised up. There's some other cool printing as well at the top for like parchment and window pieces. All in all, I think it's a really great set. Of course, you have to do what you can with the back. For the price, it's a pretty good price for Lord of the Rings at less than 10 cents per piece for this. And it'll be cool if you do have Rivendell. You can put it next to it and show the light and the dark side of Lord of the Rings. It does come with a gift of purchase. The gift of purchase is the Fel Beast. Now, this is a Nazgul, if you've watched the movies. It's an 18-plus set, 269 pieces. It does come with a Wraith and I don't think it's the Witch King of Angmar because it doesn't have the crown. I think that that would be an important indication. It just have a cloak with a face on it, kind of boring. The Fel Beast itself has a couple of the winglets that are cloth. I mean, it doesn't look good at all. I think that they just kind of piece this thing together, and the only, I think, rare pieces will be the cloth and maybe the face, but people want it because it's a gift of purchase for it, and it's Lord of the Rings, and it's the only way you can get it. So if you want to get it, likely go in on June 1st and try to purchase that when the set does come out. LEGO has a new gift with purchase over at LEGO.com. This is a LEGO Alien Space Diner. You'll get it free with a purchase of $100 or more. It comes with two space figures, one in white, one in orange. And they have these fun little drinks that are trans blue and purplish. The monster or like a tentacle beast is the diner attender, I guess, making those burgers and handing them out. There's different little memorabilia, and it's got a turquoise and white tiled floor, so very much the old school diner style to it. I like the little sign that says diner. It's a 2x4 tile with a old school neon lettering of diner to it. So it's not a bad set for a gift with purchase. It's only $100. You're going to get two classic space figures, and then you get a little diner that you could build onto to have a full-scale diner that even have spaceships come in and enjoy a little bit of, a space burger and some classic cosmic drinks. Monkie Kid is celebrating its 5th anniversary, and they've already released a small promotional set. It comes with the Monkie Kid 5th anniversary cake, as well as a couple other different areas, and it's just in the APAC region, and that means that, well, we can't get it unless we're in that country. The package comes with the Monkie Kid's mini mech and a booklet. Posted a couple pictures. The mech itself is one of the ones that we've seen before. This one has the addition of a little card that pops up that has the booklet of the characters kind of in the gold form that they've done before. And then the cake is just a 2-tiered cake with different creatures or things that we've seen on there. There's a pig, there's a monkey, there's a bee, there's a couple other things. And then on the top, there's a monkey character with a little 2x4 tile that has the number 5 on it with intricate designing. And the figure itself has glasses that have 15 or 5 imprinted on it, which I think are really cool glasses. The promotion is, I think, nice for something to celebrate like this. They did that for friends, but it was for the employees only. So this one, I'm not sure if you can get it yourself or it's just going to be for influencers in that area. The set having you also get a mech is a cool addition for all those that love Monkey Kid. Maybe you want to get your hands on this somehow. Jurassic World summer sets have been revealed. The few that we've gotten is the Baby Bumpy Ankylosaurus. It's 359 pieces at $25, and it's pretty cute. It's got just the 4 basic legs, but it's got a 2x2 tile eyes that make it look like a little baby because it's a pretty small form. But they've done the angling really well for the shell since it's more of a spherical back plate of armor, and it's in a dark turquoise coloring to it, and having it a 7+ set makes it pretty accessible to a lot of people that can build that. The dinosaur mission Stegosaurus Discovery is 420 pieces at $65, and of course you're going to get a Stegosaurus. There's 2 vehicles that come with it, more so one vehicle, a truck that has a little trailer to it where it looks like it's a satellite collection device or connection device so that they can track and find the Stegosaurus. I'm pretty sure that they've made the Stegosaurus before, but I could be wrong. The printing is really nice on it with the two-tone color of a tan and a olive green. And then there's somebody on top of a, it looks like a tree with a tree outpost trying to look and find it as well. Another one, the Dinosaur Missions Allosaurus Transport Truck. It's 555 pieces at $90, and the Allosaurus is, well, it's impressive, and I don't know if this crate that they're towing would actually handle it. It's got a semi-truck towing it, and they have a little ATV riding behind it, and a little drone, I'm guessing, to watch to see, well, to make sure everything's in order, but it looks like the cage is already broken open and the Allosaurus is on its way out. So that's this summer's Jurassic World sets. So there's a few that are definitely fun to build, and definitely collecting those different dinosaur figures. Just a couple weeks ago, we had a tiny Simba build that you can get. I think it was only like 300 or 400 pieces, but now they've come out with a large-scale Simba from The Lion King. It's a 1,445-piece set. It's 18-plus inches tall and will be... It's an 18-plus set, not inches. And it will be released on June 1st. And this was part of the leak that happened this past year, outlining some of the sets that were coming out. And it looks exactly like it. So I'm expecting the rest of them to be pretty much the closest to what was leaked before. It is a well-done set. They have the perfect eyes and the eyebrows to make him look characteristic. The tail is actually a little brown bush piece or grass piece that they've done before. And I think you can open and close the mouth. Other than that, not superposable. The animal looks great. I think it also has a lot of detailing that they used for the Lego Ideas cat that came out. If you're a big Lion King fan and love Simba, it's a great set. They did a great job. And this is probably in long... it doesn't have the 100th anniversary for Disney, but it should be, because this is one of their iconic moments, how The Lion King became their most popular animated movie. I don't know if it's of all time, but I would say definitely my generation. Lego's worked with video games before to create some models, the Overwatch, and they also did one with Horizon, the Zero Dawn series, which is Zero Dawn, the Forbidden West, and Horizon Call of the Mountain. There's so many really cool expansions to this, and they did the Tall Neck, and I'm excited to see that they might be coming out with another or something in connection with it. The head of the Guerrilla Gaming Horizon franchise came out and said that there's something in the works, that it's a well-known IP and it's ready to go. I'm not sure if that means that we're going to get a crossover of the video games or we're going to get a new Lego set. I honestly hope that it's a new Lego set. It would be really cool if they did like the Thunderjaw, or I think the elephant was rumored as a Lego set. I think I posted it probably 4 or 5 months ago that somebody else either had built and looked like a leak or what it would be. But the set is beautiful. I have it on my display in the background because it's an amazing game, really creative way of building, and I think they did a wonderful job in the reproduction of it. So I'm looking forward to hopefully getting a Lego set. But if it's a game, that would also be cool to have that mod on there and enjoy playing Horizon as a Lego alloy and venturing through the wastelands. I guess not wastelands, but the jungled expansion of this world. Lego Icons is coming out with a new ship. We've had ships before, the USS Constitution, the Maersk container ships, but this one looks to be the Endurance ship and coming out in September. This is the first of the Imperial Transatlantic Expedition done by Sir Ernest Shackleton. And the ship itself didn't... they did live, but they had some insane tales to tell. They were stuck on the ice shelf, and they had to be rescued. Going into the Atlantic and on a wooden sailing ship, I think, is pretty crazy to do. And I think the ship will be really well done, as they've done them before for Pirates of the Caribbean. And of course, they've done a lot of the pirate ships recently with the callback to the 90th anniversary. So this will be a beautiful idea set. Hopefully, for a lot of the shipbuilders or expedition lovers, the Endurance is a ship that calls to, well, that exploratory nature in humans. LEGO has been collaborating with Fortnite, as we all know, and they've come out with something unique because they released their crossover on May the 4th with LEGO Star Wars. And to do this, they will have a little trailer and a little mod. And one of the key things in the trailer is that portal opens up and a Star Destroyer flies through being damaged and kind of coming down to crashing. And they've released a new promotional product that was limited edition. It's a metal plate of an art piece with one of the Fortnite figures, well, a couple of them, running away as a Star Destroyer falls from the sky. There are only 225 of them made, and a lot of people have been posting them that are either Fortnite influencers. I haven't seen any LEGO influencers posting for it, but at 225 out of 225, that's a pretty small number. I think the artwork looks beautiful because it's kind of a screenshot of the game through and the trailer bit. And for all the Star Wars fans out there, this would be a beautiful piece to put behind maybe some of those Fortnite builds that you either have built or would love to create. There's a rumored Zelda set. Now, this was also part of the leak that happened a little over a year ago, but it looks like we're going to get a little bit of an adaption here with, instead of one great Deku tree, there's possibly going to be two, and there are going to be different minifigures. We looked at maybe one or two Links, and it looks like we're going to get four Link minifigures and a Zelda minifigure. Now, does that mean that we'll get two separately? It's not entirely... Well, it's rumored that this could be one set, a large set, at 2,500 pieces and about $300. So we're not really sure if that aligns specifically with just the one tree or not, but I'd love to see, you know, Zelda's castle instead. I don't really know the story of the tree, and that's probably because I'm not really deep in the Link lore. I love the Tears of the Kingdom, which I've been playing pretty frequently now, and I think having this become a more appropriate set for LEGO to go towards is great, because the people have loved the Zelda franchise and would love to see more sets like this, similar to how they're doing Mario Kart and the Animal Crossing line. So stay tuned, most likely revealed in September, and prepare for some more Nintendo love of Link and the Adventures of Zelda. Now, a lot of engineers want to create some new 3D processes and understanding how to manage metals and different materials, and a group in China has decided that they want to do the same thing, but with liquid, and they've created some interesting ways of designing the understanding of fluids and in motion and control using a system that is similar to Lego. These little blocks that can be pieced together have different kind of rows or avenues that the liquid can travel down, and how can they piece it together in exactly the way they want it. The liquid can be changed in these different forms in tubes, and using the tube being printed in this Lego-like form can give it the specific design that they want, right angles specifically for vein-like systems for the body, and other studies that could be created for electronics, all different aspects of it, but with liquid, which is something that I haven't seen before, because liquid is pretty much controlled by one direction and different tubing. But this is on a smaller scale and could create an entirely new network of systems that can be molded around and through, instead of having large-scale tubing systems that can't be modified. Really cool. Honestly, I love the idea of using the bricks so they can take it apart and replace it to have that Tetris and puzzle-like scale to it. Lego has put a lot of effort into their movement with Epic Games for Fortnite, and a lot of people have said, well, you know, Lego has their own video games, so moving into Fortnite was a good idea, but why? And I personally think that it was because Epic Games has some amazing products like Fortnite that a lot of people play. Same with Minecraft. Those games have a large audience in the younger generation, so that's what they want. Instead of their own direct sales, which takes a lot of physical effort and designing, they can team up with companies like this to build products or integrate their products with them. Carrie Vander Nelson, head of play and creativity growth at Lego Company, said the vision for the two companies is very similar. I think Epic Games is a leader when it has to do with digital play, whereas we at Lego are a leader when it comes to do it with physical play. So we're building really nicely on top of each other's capabilities. Now, does that also say that we're going to get some Fortnite sets? Most likely. As Lego said, we're a physical company, so building Lego sets that go along with this just makes sense. So as Lego continues to reduce its emissions, they're looking to tie it with more incentive to employees, as they're going to tie them to bonuses. The goal was to reduce to zero emissions by 2050, and they're doing a series of climate control efforts, scope 1, 2, and 3 of the supply chain emissions. And they've invested almost $2 billion already to do this. And right now, the biggest one that they're looking for is scope 3 is business travel emissions. Now, does that mean that it's specifically for employees? It's possible, but it also could be for supply, as they use a lot of air travel to ship things around the world. And building new factories within the larger scale locations like the United States just makes sense. So it could be a nice addition for them to continue processing this and trying to reach those goals, so that employees can get those well-earned bonuses, and also having emissions reduced to net zero or negative, I think it is, so we can give back to the environment. And the Lego group is just one, and I think that they're a really big push for large companies to see that it is possible to do. May 15th, Lego released two sets for a mid-May release, which doesn't happen very often. We've got the Artemis Launch System rocket, which is 3,601 pieces and stands at over 2 feet tall. And we have the Milky Way Galaxy, which is 3,091 pieces, and it has a three-dimensional view to it. I haven't gone and seen either myself, but they're very creative builds and along the lines of these NASA and Space Summer. Highly recommend if you're a space nerd, if you don't have the shuttle, to get that. But the Artemis rocket is the future of our travel back to the moon, so that would be a fun set to build as well. The third one, the lunar rover that I thought was coming out at this time, isn't coming out till August, so I'll have to be waiting for that, as I think that is the best of the three. The Lego City delivery truck has some new images for it. This truck is $100 and it looks great. They've done a wonderful design with the truck itself, having these different panels open up on the side for Lego bricks can be taken out that all have different printings on them. The different printings are from different Lego City sets. So we have fire, we have helicopter, And it's really cool. They've done a great job to build a nostalgic vehicle around this that you can transport your Lego sets through your Lego community and enjoy having a new semi in your city. Lego Ideas had a contest where you could enter to have your design as a gift with purchase. And they have finally revealed the winner of this. After 15 finalists were chosen and votes were taken, the Autumn Snails will be our next gift with purchase. Designed by Jenga Max, it has two small snails, one a little bit smaller than the other. I think it's a 4x4 round dish and then a 6x6 round dish. And they've got this one traveling on a log and another one just traveling on the ground. They're cute. They're just a little bit small. But it's a fun gift with purchase, more along the nature line and the botanical line. So you can add these little guys to a botanical set, which could be a fun time to do a gift with purchase. So when they come out with the next series, they could have this as that. But we have a lot of other ones still in the works, so this will just be added to the long list. And that's our breaking news this week. Thank you so much for everyone tuning into the podcast. I really appreciate you listening. Make sure to subscribe to the podcast as well as the YouTube channel, Back to Brick. And you can go check out our Instagram at Back to Brick 2. You can leave me a message or let me know if there's anything you'd like to see or hear of the podcast or the YouTube, and I will try my best to achieve that for you. Now we're going to move into our set reviews. Our first is the Lego set 10297 Botanical Hotel. It's an 18 plus set, 3,066 pieces, 1,495 insiders points. Comes with 7 minifigures and at a cost of $230. It has 210 reviews at 5 stars. This is part of the Icons line. I have to say, first of all, it's beautifully done. They did a wonderful job in creating an angular model for this boutique style of hotel. Instead of just a standard tower or something that's plain, they've designed it like old city style with a lot of brickwork, some cascaded rooftop area, and beautifully colored, where they have like a dark nougat for the bottom floor and a lighter nougat for the middle floor and the almost like copper, not copper. Oxidized copper, a green roof to it. The hotel has a curved section that splits, and there's a little store next to it. And of course, each floor has very detailed sections where you can go and get your keys because, well, we don't just have the key cards. Why would we do that? When it's a boutique hotel, you're going to go and get a key off the wall. The rooms are eclectic because they have that curve to them. There's little bedrooms and a little TV. They put a chocolate on your pillow, of course, because they have to do that. And then that little shop next to it is a little art piece where they've art gallery. We've got a couple printed art pieces, more of a modern art gallery. And this is one of the corner pieces to your modular series. So this will, they usually do two in the series, then they start the next one. So I believe this is the end of this series, and we're going to get the next one with, I think they just came out with the next one, just as a standard build to it. It comes with 7 minifigures, all classic, yellow faced, and they have two, what would you call it? Bellboys? One's or like bag boy, a boy and a girl are that, and a coffee shop or like barista and the artist host, and all really fun minifigures that go along with the hotel line. I used to collect the modulars. I've kind of moved on from that because, well, it just got really expensive. This one is on the list. It's just a beautiful model and definitely a way to have a little creativity and design that is not in on the same page as just a standard building. Now we're moving on to our mock review. This is the midi-scale Barad-dûr mock by Dobie1479. Because the Barad-dûr set just came out, why not have a smaller build that you might be able to afford? Because this is only 1,084 pieces and a cost of 12 euros to buy, 12 pounds to buy, not euros, excuse me. It is Sauron's tower, but it is on a smaller base plate, and what they've done really well is that the tower itself, it goes through the rock structure. It's got a couple other smaller towers to it, in the gate system. It doesn't have any lava, just kind of the brown, dark brown rock work around it. And there is, of course, an eye at the top. I think you'd have to add your own print to it. But, and the claw pieces at the top do not have face outwards, which I think I would try and turn if I could to have that structure to it. I'd have to see it in person or build it myself to do it. And they have some chain tracks to have that circular form that adds to the base of the columns. It also comes with a fell beast kind of flying around it in a very small scale, which honestly I think looks better than the big one. So I recommend going through the link in the description so you can go and purchase this if you don't have the money to purchase the large scale one and need a little less, you have a little less space than what you would for the full scale one. All right, everyone, that is our breaking news this week. Thank you so much for tuning in. Catch me next week and check out the Brick by Brick Challenge that I'm doing, the 19 a.m. Batmobile set every day through 2024, one brick at a time. All right, I'll leave you as I always do. Get creative, get out there, and go build something.